We have the Maya Residency where originally all of us stayed, and the ceramic center is there. And we have Amaria, which is a writer's retreat. And we have Artichol, which is for sculptors, basically. But each one can stay in either or property. So it's basically located in three, so that I have writers and filmmakers and poets also coming, and I have artists coming. The idea just grew, and then it grew. Then we even did metal casting. We did bronze. And when Shakti came, or Aporish comes, or Jagannath Panda came, they all worked in ceramics, and they worked in a medium which was not painting. So that's how the whole idea of Artichol Open Studios arrived, came about, that let me have studios for artists to work in stone, fiberglass, ceramics, metal, bronze, everything. And phir hua ki, if the studios are there, we should have a residency kind of thing where people can stay. Then we should have a little library. I should have my office there. So gradually the whole idea developed into a big center. I have to thank my dad. He's an architect, and he was 81 when we started this. He's 84 years old now, and he's the one who put my dreams into blueprints. And there's another artist called Narayan. He works a lot with found material and scrap. He's like the art director. Once the structure is there, he conceptualized the inside. So we've taken a chimney from an abandoned kiln and used that as a chandelier. We've used the conveyor belt scrap. We've used the channa as screens. So he uses a lot of material which is thrown and used as, it's not even used anywhere. And we've utilized that as part of the furniture, as part of the lights, as part of the sculpture. So Narayan has really created a lot of magic inside. I have to mention Salamat. He was far-sighted about a lot of things. So without my having to face a problem, he just sorted it out. We have the Maiyar band here. We have a history of music. Baba Laudin Khan was from Maiyar, and he made this Maiyar band, which is the only heritage orchestra in the country. On one side we have Khajuraho, on the other side we have Bandhavgarh, and it's just surrounded by archaeological sites. I wanted a creative center, and I wanted it to be like a sculptural piece. I didn't want a normal creative center. I wanted the center to be like a sculptural piece.
I think Amrita has done a brilliant job. You know, it was her dream, and of course, I came in at the point where the dream seems to be beautifully realized. There's still a ways to go because actually for a residency, of course I've been to the site which is the writer's residency, and it's just stunning. You know, you have the river, you have the Tamas River. What a name! You know, that implies in Hindu philosophy all the meanings. You know, and the beautiful grass, the backdrop, the hammock, and the tented accommodation. So it's really like a writer's dream.
I see Artichol as a spark that is going to re-energize the community, the space, the region of Maihar. For years, Maihar has been a very well-known place for music, but sort of forgotten over the years. This is where Baba Alauddin Khan was invited by the Maharaja to set up a center, and he never left this place. This is where Ali Akbar Khan, Ravi Shankar, Annapurna Devi, they all cut their musical teeth. This place is magical that way.
It's a wonderful haven to come into. I feel incredibly lucky that I've actually come here with a group of Indian artists. I'm the only non-Indian artist here. And so, you know, inevitably you learn a lot from other people's perception. So interacting with the way that other artists think who come from a different culture is always informs your own artwork.